and they are planning an asteroid to hit Boxford City.
Oh no, D!
Maximum thrust has been achieved. We have officially made it into space.
Attending Boxford City's fair, feast your eyes.
These are heroes of Goo Jit Zu, Galaxy Attack.
You can stretch them, you can squeeze them, and they even have galactic goo inside, captured from deep in space. These things are something like you've never played with before. And check it out. Feast your eyes on the air vac thrash. This Goo Jit Zu has a superpower unlike any others. He's able to release his vacuum seal. And when you're ready, pump him up to vacuify him. Doing so will allow you to stretch him into any position you want. Kicking, fighting, so he can defend the galaxy against the evil
Goo Jit Zu. Who would like a Goo Jit Zu? Get your Goo Jit Zu here.
Yo, sir, how about you? Would you like
heroes of Goo Jit Zu, Galaxy Attack?
Who are you talking to? There is no one here but me.
I'm talking to everyone of Boxford City. Whoever would like a Goo Jit Zu is welcome to come up and grab one, brand new. Would you like one?
No, I already have one. His name is Saturnaut, and he is super duper stretchy. I'm out of here.
All right, well, if anyone else would like a Goo Jit Zu, please. Please, feel free to get one. You there, you with the top hat. You could use a Goo Jit Zu. Grab yourself one right now.
Woo! What are these?
Yes, sir, we've got all of them. Would you be interested in Krusty Coin? His eyeball can stretch out. Very rare, Goo Jit Zu.
I don't know, he looks a little too evil for me.
Very well then. You could use Sunfire Blaziken. He's super gooey and ready for intergalactic travel with his visor. Here you go.
Ooh, I like the sound of that. Sunfire Blaziken. He'll never leave my side. I shall pass him down one day to my great-great-grandson, who will also be named Phil.
Very well, sir. A beautiful idea.
Heyo, what is going on, everyone? It's Papa Jake, and welcome back to a brand new video, continuing Boxford City Week. And if you guys aren't familiar with Boxford City Week, we just finished a crazy build of an apartment that has, well, it's disintegrated.
Jake, it is not much of an apartment anymore. Look at it.
It is, it's not looking too good. We've had a lot of rain. Okay, guys, I have something super important to tell you. I haven't
even told—
Whoa, Phil, what?
You gotta check this out.
What
Look
is it?
What I found in my great pappy's chest.
It's a Goo Jit Zu, Phil. They're like super cool.
What do you mean?
You've never seen a Goo Jit Zu before?
No!
They're intergalactic warriors, okay? They're fighting for control of the cosmos, the galaxy.
Looks like you got a super stretchy one.
It's actually pretty sweet.
Hey, look at that. Oop da, oop da, oop da.
All his power into one fist for a punch of a lifetime.
Aren't you forgetting something?
That's right, Logan. Actually, I am forgetting something, and it's a good thing you brought this over, Phil, because I almost forgot that Goo Jit Zu and Moose Toys are actually sponsoring this video. So big shout out to them for sponsoring and sending us all these awesome Goo Jit Zus that can fight and stretch and do awesome battle stuff.
But Jake, he's special. He can talk to me.
Phil, you're just imagining things.
Goo Jit Zus don't talk.
No, he does, Jake. I just can't understand him. He doesn't speak English.
He is talking, but you've got his visor on, dude. Hold on.
Oh, guys, thank you for letting me be able to talk. I've been trying to tell your friend Phil here. He's in grave danger. You see, our fight against the other Goo Jit Zus has gone terribly wrong. At one time, the galaxy was held evenly by Goo Jit Zus, good and bad. But now the bad ones are taking over, and they are planning an asteroid to hit Boxford City and destroy all of it. Some of my closest brothers are on that asteroid, held prisoner by the bad Goo Jit Zus.
I just can't believe he can talk.
There's no meteorite. I don't see a meteorite coming.
Phil, I think your Goo Jit Zu's broken. He's talking about an asteroid.
What do you mean, Jake? He just told us there's an asteroid coming.
I'm not making things up, and I'm not broken. You have to understand. The asteroid is heading your way. Just ask my brothers.
I don't know about this asteroid. In fact, the sky looks, well, kind of cloudy, but there is no asteroid up there trying to hit Boxford City. Okay, we are going to be making the most epic Boxford City. And if any asteroid were to hit it, it wouldn't destroy it because the only thing that destroys Boxforts is water. Plus, I don't know what you're saying, your brothers, okay? Yes, I have a Goo Jit Zu. It's not like Goo Jit Zus are just everywhere.
They are everywhere, though. Just look over by that rock. It's Sergeant Airbag Thrash.
That is a mushroom. It is a gross blue mushroom.
No, it's not. You see, our Goo Jit Zus go into hiding when the bad ones come. He just needs to be unvacuum sealed. You'll see.
He's right. Everything he says is true. All of it.
And if you humans are to help us, heroes of Goo Jit Zu, we will repay you in tape rolls.
Okay, I don't know how you did that exactly, but look, okay, we're always open to earning some extra tape rolls, and if there is an asteroid going to destroy Box Fort City, then we might be down to help you guys.
Oh, great. It's starting to rain, and there's an asteroid coming for Box Fort City.
Hold on. Supposed asteroid. We need confirmation on this by our best scientists. Phil? Get up on top of the treehouse. Let us know.
All right, Jake, I'll go check it out. Oh no, Jake!
Okay, yes, we have confirmation there is an asteroid. All right, listen up, man. We need to save Box Fort City the only way I know how. I once saw this movie where they blew something up to stop it from blowing up Earth, I think. That may be an asteroid. It might have also been underwater. I don't remember exactly. Look, I have an idea. Phil, you still have that TNT?
Always!
See this old apartment building? We're gonna turn this into a spaceship and we're gonna pay this asteroid a visit.
What? Jake, how are we gonna turn this into a spaceship? It's falling apart.
It's a bit of a fixer-upper, but I think with our building skills, it'll be the biggest spaceship we've ever built. We'll put a payload at the bottom to blow up the asteroid, and we'll have a command center at the top. Then we'll have living quarters in the middle. The thruster should be enough to get us to that asteroid in time, blow it up, and get back to Earth. Plus Airvac Thrash, we'll save any of the other good Goo Jit Zus on that asteroid.
Jake, why does he look like that?
He's in his airvac mode. See, look, I actually found it. Looking on the back here. You just press a button, and you can vacuum out the air. And then, he turns back into super squishy. Look at that! How cool is that?
Please, do not do that! We don't have time!
Like he's saying, we do not have time!
Okay, alright, Phil, grab the TNT and all of our spaceship building supplies. Logan, you get the cardboard and tape. I'll take the vlog and chill with you guys. Hey, what's up? If you guys haven't liked the video yet, do not forget to smack that like button down below. And of course, if you want a shout out at the end of this video, all you gotta do is leave a comment down below, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell button, and of course, join the squad! And of course, if you guys want to check out any more information on Goo Jit Zus, there'll be all of the info down below in the description. But guys, we have a spaceship to build, and this is going to be the biggest spaceship. Okay guys, after a ton of work and a lot of building, we have successfully made the largest Box Fort rocket that will ever take off from planet Earth. We are going to be heading on this rocket all the way to the asteroid that's coming and potentially going to blow up Box Fort City. So I've actually gone and made the control room at the top. I've got my Goo Jit Zu here who's going to be helping me pilot the ship and get us to that asteroid. Below you can see the thruster that Phil has been working on. This is a working thruster that'll actually move the rocket ship up, and then we have the payload. This is going to drop with us into space, allowing me to set it up on the asteroid, plant the detonation, save all the Goo Jit Zus, get back to the ship, and get back home for dinner. Hopefully, unless something goes wrong. And of course, because Logan's Logan, he built himself a first class pod. So
we have to go in a first class luxury space pod. So we got tons of snacks. We got a freezer with some drinks in it. And we even got a coffee machine.
I don't know how long the space journey is going to be, but I do know it's going to be comfy.
All right. And now, guys, welcome to the control room. We have everything we need in here to pilot this spacecraft. I also have a brand new steering system that I can use to pilot the spacecraft. I've got my thruster controls over here, which will allow me to adjust the thrust on the actual craft. And I've got some new fancy pedals down here that I can use for tilting and turning around the spacecraft. And probably the most important feature is our payload dispatch system. Once I click all three of these keys, it is going to drop the payload below this rocket, allowing us to then put it on the asteroid, thus blowing it up and saving all our Goo Jit Zus.
Jake, the weather is beginning to turn. We must take this spaceship off now if we are going to succeed in the mission.
You're right. You're so right. I bet Logan's having a blast down in first class. You know, he always gets to stay in first class, and I've got the really serious hard job of actually taking this thing off. You know how stressful that is?
All right, Phil and I are in first class, traveling in style. We're just gonna chill out.
Yeah, Logan, would you like your pre-flight coffee?
I won't say no.
All right, I'm on it.
important when you're flying to space to not leave on an empty stomach.
The whole gang's here.
We are ready for takeoff.
All right, Captain, we ready to take off?
Yes, Jake, I think it's time.
You want to do the honors?
Of course. Let's do this. I may not have enough power.
Okay, yeah, you know what? Why don't you just sit over here and you can be co-pilot. I'll take it from here. Activating the first thruster module. Second thruster module. Power looks good. Turning on these red buttons because they do something. I don't really know what. Changing throttle to max. Gearing up system. Flight pedals are working and confirmed. Here we go. All right, everyone, if you can hear me down there in box four first class, just letting you know we're taking off now on a very important space mission. Starting engines in 3, 2, 1, firing engines. Okay, engines are firing. Beginning to adjust thrust module, putting up thrust. To maximum. Maximum thrust has been achieved. Okay. Hold on there. This might be a bumpy ride. Oh! Okay, screen is falling over. Logan, hold on down there, buddy.
Logan, I got your coffee. Oh, whoa, whoa. Logan, fail! Ah! No! It's hot coffee! Maybe I shouldn't have given me his coffee yet.
Oh, she really wants to turn right. Co-pilot!
Jake, I am not prepared to fly a human spacecraft.
Okay, just hold on. Use your weight to hold this here while I fix the monitor. Okay, thank you. All right, balancing out. And stratosphere has been reached. We are floating in space. This is Papa Jake to the rest of the crew. We have made it to space. Powering down thrusters now. And we are drifting towards the asteroid.
Jake, please tie me down.
Well, guys, we have officially made it into space.
Phil, I am completely soaked. This is not first class treatment.
Yeah, maybe coffee on a spaceship wasn't the right idea.
We are good. And it looks like our star map has been activated. It's our sun, so we are on the right trajectory for the asteroid. So, now, all we gotta do is make sure we're on the right trajectory towards the asteroid. And once we get there, release this payload. I guess I'm just gonna be up here for a while.
Okay, Logan, well, seeing as though we've been in space for a while, I thought what better time than to give you your first class dinner for this evening.
Ooh, looks like human food.
I call it space pizza.
I don't know why I'm always treated like a king whenever we travel, but I like it.
Would you like any fresh beverages to wash that down?
No, I definitely don't need coffee spilt all over me. So no.
No more beverages.
We have water too.
Okay. Food is a little bit stale. I'm not exactly loving the first class treatment right now.
All right, guys, so it's been a little while now, and we are officially coming up on the asteroid. It is now time to put this machine in full effect. Let's bring this bad boy in and close to this asteroid.
Jake, once we get close to the asteroid, there will be a lot of retaliations from the other Goo Jit Zus. You're gonna have to fight through them. And remember, they have some of our best men on that asteroid.
It is imperative, Papa Jake, that we save Pantaro. Each Goo Jit Zu holds its own power. Power of water blast. Like me with my air vac, allowing me to shield up and become as strong as a diamond. Even Sunfire Blazagon has the power of squishiness, allowing him to absorb attacks. And with his space visor, he can breathe in space far longer than any of us.
You know what? It's a good thing you reminded me, because I was about to just... the asteroid, so... I will remember that. We've got Goo Jit Zus on the asteroid. We gotta save them. All right, bringing us in close. All right, switching to manual precision mode. One little closer. All right, powering down thrusters. We're drifting now, getting right into position, but I do not want to get lost in the gravity field. Okay, activating clamp system now.
There, I can see them, my brothers. Jake, you must save them!
Okay, activating the robotic arm now and grabbing the good Goo Jit Zus.
Alright, well, it looks like we have to save Pantaro from this asteroid and collect any other Goo Jit Zus who are on there.
Locked in, bringing them into the airlock.
Okay. Goo Jit Zus are all locked and inside the airlock.
Well, it looks like in the end we were able to save Krusticoid, even though he might be evil and has a really freaky eyeball that pops out. Luckily though, we were able to save Saturnot. Him with his super stretchy ability is definitely going to help us on our missions. Also, he might be evil, but Air Vac Orbitox doesn't look too bad either. Plus, he's got that really awesome Air Vac ability, which, personally, I love.
We are officially clear to launch the payload.
Jake! What have you done? That's Krusticoid! He's the most evil of all the Goo Jit Zus! He's on our ship!
Well, you know what? You could have maybe specified that what you saw me using the crane. You know, you could have maybe said, hey.
Don't pick up that guy, he's evil.
Oh no.
He's right! I am evil, and I am not going to allow you to blow up my asteroid. Ugh. If you think you're gonna blow up my asteroid, you're gonna have to go through me! Time to ruin your ship.
Yeah! Ah! Logan! Phil! There's a weird crusty eye thing on me!
Phil? Phil? What is that? Phil? Jake? Jake?
Get off my face!
No! Never! Not until you turn back!
You're ruining the control systems!
Where'd you go? Where'd you go?
I'm behind you!
What?
Oh! Turn back your ship now!
Jake, the airlock. You can use it. Distinguish him back into space.
You're right. I'm putting my helmet on.
Okay, activating the airlock now.
Wow! You will not defeat me!
Close.
I think we got rid of him.
Now hurry! Blow that asteroid up!
Yeah, I think I'm ready to get back to Boxford City.
Getting the payload ready. Payload is 100% armed. Ready to release in 3, 2, 1. Primary lock, secondary lock, and final lock now!
Payload is stuck, unable to move.
Oh no. With Krusticoid and me opening the airlock, it must have messed with the payload. It's stuck. I don't even have Logan and Phil to help me. They're literally in a first-class cabin. I'm gonna have to go out there and do a bit of a spacewalk. Get down to the payload and manually release it. If I can get back up here in time and put this thing in full thrust, we should be able to get out of the way of the asteroid fast enough. That is, unless you want to go in my place.
No.
All right, space helmet's on. And opening airlock now. One wrong step, and I'm going out there into space. Forever. All right, moving down spaceship and found the payload. It looks like it did drop, but it got caught on the bottom here. Arming the payload. Payload's armed. Asteroid's in sight. Dropping payload now. Looks like payload's on the right trajectory. Okay, I'm gonna get back up to the control bay and get us out of here as quick as possible. Okay. We did it. Oh no, this thing's losing power. All right, thrusters, setting them to max. Hold on, everyone down below. It's gonna be bumpy. Peter, what's your status report?
Distance is still too close to explosion.
Okay, all right, well, I'm giving her all she's got. Come on, come on.
Fuel levels almost exhausted. Automatically turning down thrusters.
Wait, no. Computer, how far are we? Are we far enough away?
Calculating. Current distance from Meteor shows a 98% probability of success.
We did it!
Guys, we did it. We've successfully gotten far enough away from the explosion. I don't know if we'll be able to see it from here. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a big explosion. That's a good thing we weren't there. Hey, we got all the Goo Jit Zus off there, right?
All my brothers are safe, thanks to you, Papa Jake. Our fight against all in the galaxy will go on. It never ends. We will continue to fight.
Yeah, yeah, no, that's okay. We get it. We understand. At least we saved Boxforce City.
Guys, we did it. We officially saved Boxforce City. That means that we can continue on our epic adventure and continue building the best Boxforce City of all time. Of course, if you guys did enjoy this video, do not forget to smack that like button. And if you guys want to grab yourself a Goo Jit Zu, of course, use all the links in the description down below to find out more information on where you can grab these awesome guys. I love them. They're so squishy and they have such cool features.
Jake, please do not do that to me.
All right, I forgot. You don't like being squished. You like being stretched.
But anyway, guys, this has been Papa Jake. And of course, I will see you guys next time for another awesome video.